I am Dr. W.P. Gunnade from Kamalanil Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today we are discussing the structures of tetranuclear and hexanuclear metal clusters. Already we have discussed binuclear and trinuclear metal clusters and the structure and bonding in case of tetranuclear. And in case of tetranuclear, there are four atoms which are joined by the multiple metal-metal bonds. And in this case, hexanuclear and tetranuclear examples are. In case of tetranuclear, example is the tungsten W4Cl8, W4Cl12, W4Cl16 are the examples. Tungsten is the metal, and in this case, this compound is having different structures, and this tetranuclear in which the metal-metal bonds are there, and also in the case of hexanuclear, molybdenum is the compound Mo6. Cl8 4+ is the example of hexanuclear. So in today's part we are discussing the structures of the metal cluster, and particularly the tetranuclear and hexanuclear metal clusters. So today's topic is cluster 2, and in this case metal metal bonds we are discussing, and today's part we are discussing the two important metal cluster, tetranuclear and hexanuclear metal clusters. So, in case of tetranuclear metal complexes or metal cluster, tetran is 4, and in case of tetranuclear, 4 metal atoms are present in the cluster compound. And in this type metal cluster, there are 4 metal atoms, and then these 4 atoms have metal-metal multiple bonds. And example of this type is the W4OR12, W4OR16. These are the compound tungsten OR12 and W4OR16. OR is the ligand, and which is known as the alkoxide. So OR is the alkoxide, methoxide, ethoxide, peroxide, like that. And structure of this first compound W4OR12 is shown in this figure. So 4 tungsten are here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this O means nothing but the OR, alkoxide. So here, this tungsten have 1, 2, 3 alkoxide, and this is the bridge alkoxide. Again, 2 are here, and these are the bridge alkoxide. Here, here, here is one, here are the 2 and 2, and these are the 4, and these 2 are the alkoxides. So this is the structure shown here, 4 tungsten and the 12 alkoxides are there. So this is the structure of the tetranuclear metal complex, and in this case O is nothing but the alkoxide or OR isoperoxide. So in this case the structure of W4OR12 is shown in this figure, and this structure of W4OR12, it is nothing but the dimer of the W2OR6. So this is the monomer, and dimerization of this we get the W4OR12, and W4OR12 cluster is unsaturated, which contain the double bond, and this cluster shows dynamic intramolecular rearrangement. And because of this position of double and single bond keep on exchanging in the W4 ring at the room temperature, the alkoxy ligand also exchange between the bridge and terminal position. So both the bridge and terminal positions are there in the structure, and similar to this structure of W4OR12, the structure of W4OR6 is also shown. So here, similar to this compound, the structure of W4OR16 is also shown, and this is the structure shown. 4 tungstens are here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, now there are bridging alkoxide here, and again here too, and total 16 alkoxides are there. So these are the terminal and these are the bridge. So this is the structure for W4OR16. So alkoxides are 16, ligand, and metals are W4. So two structures have been shown here for our tetranuclear metal cluster, W4OR12 and W4OR16. And as we know, W416 is a tetrameric saturated cluster and which contains the tungsten single bond. And each tungsten has terminal as well as bridging alkoxide ligand, which is shown in the structure. And another example of tetranuclear cluster is MO4Cl4PR34. This is another structure of the tetranuclear in which molybdenum metals are formed. The tetrameric molybdenum compound or complex, this cluster is formed by dimerization of K4MoCl8. So which is shown here, this is the K4MoCl8 plus PR3. So here we get MO4Cl8PR4. So in this way we get the structure, and PR3 is the trialkyl phosphine, and the four molecules join there and we get this type of compound. So dimerization of this compound and we get the tetranuclear metal complex. So these are the examples of tetranuclear metal clusters or complex. And next is the example of this compound, that is MoCl4PR34 is shown here. And the structure of this molybdenum cluster is shown here. So here molybdenum, another molybdenum 2, this is 3 and 4. And total PR3 are 4, so one is here, another on second metal, third and fourth. And 4 Cl's are there, so one Cl is here, another Cl2, this is 3 and this is 4. And there are also bridging Cl, so here Cl8, so MoCl8PR34. So in here should be a 8 Cl8, so 4 terminal and 4 bridging Cl's are there and 4 PR3 are there. So this is the structure of MO4Cl8PR34. So this is the molybdenum metal cluster forming this type of compound. And between the molybdenum, here is a triple bond. Between these two molybdenum, here is triple bond, but here is a double bond between these two, and here is a single bond. So single bond, triple, double, both are there between the two metal, and forming this type of structure of the molybdenum cluster. So we can say that in case of the four membered ring, which is shown in the structure, because of all molybdenum bonds are not identical, it has the alternate molybdenum single bond, then molybdenum triple bond. So alternate bonds are there, single bond, triple bond. Triple bonds are shorter and single bonds are longer. Therefore this structure become a rhombohedral. So the structure of this molybdenum metal cluster is rhombohedral. Four molybdenum atoms are in one plane, and out of two bridging Cl, one is above and other below the plane. So each MO has one terminal PR3 and one terminal Cl, and out of which one is above and other is below the plane. So in this way, arrangement of this molybdenum metal clusters are shown here. So in this structure, one Cl above the plane and other below the plane. Similarly here, in this case also PR3 above the plane and Cl below the plane, the structure is shown here. So the structure is known as the rhombohedron. So this structure of the molybdenum metal cluster is a rhombohedron. So these are the examples of the tungsten or molybdenum are the example of these tetranuclear metal complexes. And these are more tetranuclear metal complexes which are known as carbonyl metal clusters. So here this is the structure of IR4CO12, this is IR1234, other is tetradally, and these are the carbonyls. 12 carbonyls are there. These are also the metal clusters, but the ligand is carbonyl. This is another structure. This structure is obtained when we combine CO2-CO8, and there is a loss of 4CO. When we heat, we get CO4-CO12. So in this way, cobalt, this is the tetra-cobalt dodeca carbonyl. So this is again tetranuclear metal complex. but in which the these are the four cobalt are stated. See the arrangement. And now there are carbonyl group, and both the, in this case both the carbonyls are there, bridge as well as terminal carbonyls are present. So these two structures of erbium 4 and the cobalt 4 are the examples of tetranuclear metal clusters. Next is the pentanuclear metal cluster. Actually, in case of pentanuclear pentanuclear metal clusters without carbon, or we can say without carbonyl, are not known, but with the carbonyl there some metal clusters are there. So without carbonyl metal clusters are not known, and as here metal nuclear metal clusters without carbonyl are shown. So these are the metal pentanuclear metal carbonyl, but what is here, no without carbonyl no other metal clusters of pentanuclear are known. So this is the example in which five metals are there, 1 2 3 4 5. In this case 1 2 3 4 5, so 5 nickel and 5 iron, and remaining are shown. These are the carbonyl groups, these are the bridging and the terminal, these are the terminal and these are the bridging carbonyl. In this case also shown, this is the terminal carbonyl, and some are the bridging carbonyl are shown. So this is the arrangement of the 5, and in this case no bridging, all are the, in this case no bridging carbonyl, all are the terminal carbonyl shown. So these are the 5 metal cluster, and iron form this type of metal cluster with the carbonyl group, and nickel also form metal cluster in which the 5 metal atoms are there and form the metal cluster with the carbonyl groups. But other than carbonyl, no pentanuclear metal clusters are known. Second is the next part is the hexanuclear metal clusters. Actually, in case of hexanuclear, there are 6 metal atoms are present. Molybdenum, niobium, tantalum are the examples. And these atoms have been known for many years, and hexanuclear metal clusters are mainly two types. These hexanuclear metal clusters are two types. First type is, in case of first type, octahedron of the 6th metal is coordinated with the 8 chloride ligand, and Cl is at each face of the octahedron. So here example is MO6Cl8 is the metal cluster. MO6Cl8 is the cluster, and this MO6Cl8 cluster formed by the hexamerization of the MOCl2. So hexamer of this MOCl2, we get this compound hexamerization. And how it forms is shown here. So 6 molecular MOCl2 forming this type of MO6Cl12, and in which 4 Cl is removed and we get MOCl4+. So this is the compound which is known as hexanuclear metal cluster. So in this way they form by the hexamerization of MOCl2, and we get the first MO6Cl12, and from which the 4 Cl ions are removed, and MOCl4+ is the metal cluster is formed. So this is the one type. So in the first type, 6 metal is coordinated with the 8 chloride ligand. So in case of first an octahedron, 6 metal is coordinated with the 8 chloride ligand, and Cl is at the each face of the octahedron. Example is MO6Cl8. So this is one type of hexanuclear metal cluster, and in this case the structure is shown here. So structure of this MOCl8 4+ is shown here. This is the structure in which this circle is the Cl and solid circle is the molybdenum. So here molybdenum is shown. These are the molybdenum MOCl8. So these are the circles, and molybdenum is at the center. So structure of MO6Cl8. This is the structure of MO6Cl8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the metal in molybdenum, and these are the 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 are the Cl. So this is the structure. Hollow circle is the Cl, and solid circle is the molybdenum. And structure is shown how octahedron, 6 metal form an octahedron, and the molybdenum is at the here corners shown at the octahedron here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And two types are there, metal and ligands. So molybdenum and chloride are shown in this structure. So this is the structure for W4. This is the structure for MO6Cl8 4+. It is an hexanuclear, and we have seen the structure here how it is formed. So we can say here, in case of the above cluster, molybdenum 2+ has D4 configuration, and each molybdenum 2+ use its 4 unpaired electron to form the 4 covalent bond with the adjacent 4 MO2+, and this MO2+ coordinate with the has a coordinate bond with the 4 Cl ligand. So in case of cluster, we have seen there are 12 molybdenum single bonds, that is total 24 electrons are involved in the metal-metal bonding. And other example of this type is a MO6S8 4-. This is another example. MO6S8 4- is the other example of hexanuclear metal clusters. So hexam is 6 metal atoms are present in the cluster. Second class of the hexanuclear is the hexanuclear metal cluster, and this type also contain an octahedron of the metal, but they are coordinated by 12 halide ligands along the edges, which is shown in the structure. So again here six metals are there. So these are shown 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So here is there. So here 6, and remaining are the chloride. So 6 metal forming the octahedron, and remaining are the halide, 12 halide ions are there. So this is the structure of MO6Cl12. So 6 are there, MO6Cl12. So this is 1, 2, 3, here 4, 5 and 6 are shown. So they form an octahedron, and remaining are the 12 halide ligands present along the edges. So MO6Cl12 2+ structure of metal cluster is shown here. And in this type, MO6Cl12 2+ ion also has octahedron of the 6 molybdenum, which are coordinated by the 12 Cl along with the edges of octahedron. Niobium and tantalum are also form such type of clusters, and in such type of cluster bonding is shown and is somewhat complicated. In case of niobium 6 Cl12 2+ cluster, there are valence electrons with the 6 niobium ion which form an octahedron, and there are 16 valence electrons with the 6 niobium ion, and there are 12 niobium bonds in the clusters are there, which has 8 electron pair, and each niobium bond has 2/3 bond order. These compounds are electron having electrons similar to that of borane, and in this way they also act as a very good oxidizing agent. So such type of metal clusters, in case of niobium, they has the 2/3 bond order. These compounds are electron deficient like that of the borane, and therefore they act as a very good oxidizing agent. So in case of hexanuclear, examples are MO6Cl12 2+, and MO6Cl8+ is also there. Niobium is also there. Niobium Cl12+. So these are the important molybdenum and the niobium are the two metal clusters shown here. This is one and this is second metal clusters, which contain six metal atoms in the cluster compound. And in case of the carbonyl, hexanucleic metal clusters are shown. This is the RH6CO8-16. This is CO6 and carbonyls are there. So different structures have been shown. Here rhodium metal and here is a cobalt. So rhodium is here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And having terminal and bridging carbonyl. So RH6CO16 is shown here. This is the structure with the carbonyl. And this is a complicated structure of the cobalt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cobalt are there. And the remaining compounds are the carbonyl. And in this case, both terminal as well as bridge carbonyls are present. So this is the examples of hexanucleic metal clusters with carbonyl. Other than carbonyl, the structures are given. So in today's part, we have seen different types of examples of tetranuclear and hexanuclear metal clusters. So as we have seen, three examples of the tetranuclear, tungsten and molybdenum, and also we have discussed the hexanuclear, which contains six metal atoms in the clusters, and molybdenum and the niobium form these six metal six atom metal clusters. So these are the structures and examples of metal clusters. And so there are, as we have seen, in the classification, depending upon the number of metal atom present, there are different types of metal clusters. One is binuclear, trinuclear, tetranuclear, pentanuclear, hexanuclear, octanuclear is also there, and also decanuclear is also there. But these are the importants are binuclear, some are the trinuclear, tetranuclear also important, hexanuclear, these are the four important metal clusters.